We begin with the coronavirus pandemic and the new letter from the
CDC. We'll have to quarantine for 14 days if they want to come to the tri-state.
Go away without the vaccine?
Sure, over a period of time. Sure, with time, it goes
many deaths. And you'll develop...
Tonight at midnight, New Jersey, Connecticut, and New York will start restricting
travel. Far too many Americans who have lost loved ones to the coronavirus.
The pandemic are viewed more than a million times a day and edited almost every hour of the day.
The passengers on board were tested for the virus that some are now calling Wuhan pneumonia.
China health officials are also reporting that 7 other people are in critical condition and 41 others are suffering from pneumonia caused by the new type of coronavirus. China says the cause of the outbreak is unknown at this time, but seems to be isolated in one of the cities called Wuhan.
We want to be very clear here. American health officials don't want you to panic. They don't want you to cancel your travel plans. They just want to be ready for anything.
2003 in Beijing, I was experienced a SARS, and then that was very horrible memory to me. And so I hope this one is not that bad.
One question, whether or not they visited the city's largest meat and seafood market, where it may have first been transferred to a human in December.
I used to go there also shopping. But now I just heard it's closed.
There have been more than 800 cases now and 26 deaths.
Infected more than 800 people, including at least one person here in the United States.
Flights and trains out of Wuhan have been canceled. People living there have been told they shouldn't leave the city.
The entire city of Wuhan is under quarantine.
All these shops are closed. There's pretty much nobody on the street here. Pretty quiet on the first day of the year of the rat.
The House managers are set to finish their opening arguments in the impeachment trial of President Trump.
Meanwhile, in China, Shanghai Disneyland has closed as a preventative measure against the spread of the virus.
China's government takes control of the response to the coronavirus as work begins on a 1,000-bed hospital for victims. And Europe reports its first case of the disease.
We have some outbreaks here. We probably will have some isolated outbreaks. That doesn't mean it's going to translate into an epidemic outside of China.
The NBA legend Kobe Bryant and 8 others, including his 13-year-old daughter, Gianna, were killed in a helicopter crash earlier today.
Just today, more cases were confirmed here in the U.S., bringing the total number to at least 5. In China, where the virus is spreading quickly, at least 76 people have died. Millions there remain on lockdown to prevent the spread. Health officials are now warning of more cases to come.
The death toll from the novel coronavirus has surpassed 100, while the number of confirmed cases has risen to more than 4,500.
Meanwhile, countries around the world have been responding to the virus outbreak. The U.S. and Canada have issued travel warnings to citizens planning to visit the region. Germany, Sri Lanka, and Cambodia all recorded their first confirmed cases of the infectious disease on Monday.
The World Health Organization has declared the coronavirus a global health emergency. The respiratory disease has now killed 213 people in China, with almost 10,000 infected.
Any U.S. citizen returning to the United States who has been in Hubei province in the previous 14 days will be subject to up to 14 days of mandatory quarantine to ensure they are provided proper medical care and health screening.
The issue now with this is that there's a lot of unknowns. As you can see just from the media, the number of cases have steeply inclined each and every day.
The Philippines reporting the first coronavirus death outside of China. It's a man who traveled from Wuhan, the epicenter of the outbreak. Meanwhile, in China itself, officials say the number of dead has risen to at least 304.
The growing desperation for quarantine cruise passengers. Thousands stuck on ships like this one off the coast of Japan. At least 12 Americans among those testing positive for the virus.
The Chinese whistleblower doctor who told the world about the coronavirus in Wuhan has died.
We have a new name for the coronavirus. The World Health Organization has officially named it COVID-19. That's Co for Corona, Vi for virus, D for disease, and 19 because it started last year. The name, though, of course, isn't the most pressing concern. On Monday, China suffered the highest number of deaths in one day.
The CDC has confirmed another coronavirus infection here in the U.S. America's 15th case comes as infections skyrocket across mainland China.
Jean-Jacques Azafan-Razi is the first doctor in France who had been on the front line of caring for coronavirus patients. now dead after contracting the disease.
Hong Kong has also reported a second death from the coronavirus. The city is bracing for its first back-to-back annual recessions on record as the outbreak cripples an economy already battered by months of protests.
We're learning today, too, about 44 new cases of the new illness on board the Diamond Princess. That's the cruise ship still under quarantine in Yokohama, Japan.
After 14 days of quarantine, people who have tested negative for the coronavirus were allowed to leave Yokohama's port in a stream of vehicles through Wednesday.
Authorities in Italy have imposed a travel ban on about a dozen towns in the north of the country, an effort to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. Two people in Italy infected with the virus have died, and officials there are reporting about another 80 confirmed cases. Some 50,000 people are affected by the lockdown, which is near the city of Milan. The small town of Codogno is at the epicenter of the outbreak there.
In Washington state, they are confirming now the first U.S. death from COVID-19.
At this moment, we have 22 patients in the United States currently that have coronavirus. Unfortunately, one person passed away overnight. Additional cases in the United States are likely.
The World Health Organization saying today 80% of new cases outside China are from just three countries, Korea, Iran, and Italy. In Italy, the death toll jumping to 79 today, an increase of 27 in one day out of 2,500 infections. In South Korea, the case numbers topping 5,000. The president has declared war on the virus and called for an urgent solution to a mask shortage in the country. South Korea saying it screened more than 100,000 people for the virus, including at drive-through testing sites. The death toll there is around 28.
Another hotspot is Iran, where 8,042 people have tested positive for the virus, with 291 more deaths. Many people in Iran are self-isolating at home, avoiding going out as far as they can. Bustling cities have turned into ghost towns.
Today, the World Health Organization officially announced that this is a global pandemic. To keep new cases from entering our shores, we will be suspending all travel from Europe to the United States for the next 30 days. The new rules will go into effect Friday at midnight.
President Trump has declared a national emergency, which frees up to $50 billion in emergency funds.
At least 67 Americans have died, but the virus has spread to every state except West Virginia. As a result, the CDC says any gatherings of 50 people or more should be canceled for the next 2 months. And several states, along with big cities like New York and Los Angeles, have ordered restaurants, bars, and theaters to close.
Stay home or face punishment. The words of French President Emmanuel Macron on Monday as the French government ramped up its lockdown restrictions across the country.
Toilet paper, pasta, or meat. In just a matter of hours, these basic staples have become a rare commodity as French consumers stock up on food and hygiene products.
Zero new infections for the second consecutive day in Hubei province or the rest of China. There were 39 imported cases.
Also tonight, Hawaii's governor is now mandating a 14-day quarantine for all incoming travelers to the state. The state says all confirmed cases in Hawaii have been linked to travel or have made contact with a traveler.
Europe has seen a dramatic rise in cases and deaths, particularly in hard-hit Italy. It's reporting more than 59,000 total confirmed cases with over 5,400 deaths.
Without a huge national effort to halt the growth of this virus, there will come a moment when no health service in the world could possibly cope, because there won't be enough ventilators, enough intensive care beds, enough doctors and nurses. To put it simply, if too many people become seriously unwell at one time, the NHS will be unable to handle it.
Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe has officially announced the postponement of the Summer Olympic Games.
On March 24th, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced a complete lockdown. He said it was India's only option to limit the spread of the coronavirus.
The New York Times is writing about, at this hour, writing that scientists warn that the United States someday would become the country hardest hit by the coronavirus pandemic. That moment arrived on Thursday. They write, in the United States, at least 81,321 people have been known to be infected with the coronavirus, including more than 1,000 deaths, more cases than China, Italy, or any other country has seen, according to data gathered by the New York Times.
The UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson has tested positive for coronavirus, as has his health secretary Matt Hancock. In the United States, President Trump approved a $2.2 trillion emergency spending package to give a lifeline to the economy. There are now more than 100,000 confirmed cases in the United States.
At home, these are the states whose governors have ordered residents to stay at home to minimize the spread of the coronavirus. Ohio until April 6th, Illinois, April 15th, and Delaware, you need to stay home until May 15th, West Virginia until further notice, same with California and New York and New Jersey. Wisconsin expected to announce today, and Oregon until further notice. In Connecticut, you must stay home until April 22nd, in Nevada until April 16th, Indiana April 7th, and Pennsylvania, six counties, April 6th.
10 million Americans out of work applying for unemployment. The long lines tonight for food.
Today I'm instructing my administration to halt funding of the World Health Organization.
U.S. President Donald Trump has come under fire for encouraging protests against lockdown restrictions in three swing states run by Democrats. Trump called for Minnesota, Michigan, and Virginia to be liberated from measures that he says are too tough.
Pressured by China, EU softens report on COVID-19 disinformation.
President Donald Trump has caused alarm by suggesting people infected with the coronavirus could be treated with ultraviolet light and disinfectant.
The global death toll has reached almost 200,000. More than a quarter of all deaths have occurred in the United States, which has the world's highest number of cases.
Brazil now has recorded more than 10,000 deaths. Despite Rio being the second worst hit state in Brazil, state governor Wilson Witzel has been reluctant to order a full lockdown. Instead, he's called for better adhesion to social distancing regulations.
Brazil's coronavirus death toll has passed 20,000 as fears grow that Latin America could become the pandemic's next epicenter.
And New Zealand has confirmed two new cases of coronavirus, ending a 24-day streak of no new infections in the country. Both women had travelled to New Zealand from here in the UK.
At North Paulding High School in Dallas, Georgia, by 15-year-old Hannah Waters. And it shows students transitioning between classes. Few are wearing masks, and they are walking shoulder to shoulder through the halls. It really captures the fear felt by students, parents, and teachers alike, that despite every district's best efforts, you can't control everything.
More than 200,000 people in the U.S. who have died from COVID-19. Hundreds more die every day. Still an alarming rate of loss.
Stunning news. The President of the United States now confirming to the world that he and the First Lady of the United States have both tested positive for the coronavirus and they will quarantine.
Critical care nurse Sandra Lindsay receiving one of the first doses of the COVID-19 vaccine in the United States. She said she felt hopeful and relieved about the shot. We are in a new phase in the pandemic. The first shipments of Pfizer's vaccine, are arriving in states around the country. The U.S. has seen more than 16.3 million coronavirus cases and more than 300,000 deaths. Carl Zimmer joins me now. He's a columnist for the New York Times and also the author of the book, A Planet of Viruses. Welcome, Carl. So how does this particular vaccine work?
The Pfizer vaccine is part of a new class of vaccines that are based on a molecule called mRNA. And basically, what you're doing is you're giving your body instructions to make its own vaccine. And so once you receive the vaccine, some of your cells will make proteins from the virus. They're harmless. But what they do is they teach your immune system how to mount a defense so that if you get exposed to the real virus, you'll be able to knock it out immediately and not even know you've been infected.